We'll cover animation, how to create animations in JavaFX. To start with, what is the animation? Animation is a method in which objects are manipulated to appear as a moving images. So as we see in the cartoon films or animation films, it is basically a sequence of images that are moving in such a speed that they appear as that the objects are appearing us as a moving objects in the scene. So animation is basically a method in which objects are manipulated. Manipulated means that their state is changed or their values are changed in such a way that they are appearing us as a moving images. There are two ways of animation that are supported in JavaFX. One is timeline and another one is transition. So we have either timeline animation or we can have a transition animation. Transitions are limited to an initial and final state. In the transition animation, we have an initial state, like in this diagram, we have an initial state and we have a final stage. And the system will create a moving transition can change only between initial to final. So we have only two stages, one is initial stage, another one is final stage. And the intermediate stages will be created by the system automatically. And it is the simplest form of transition and the simplest form of animation. Another kind of animation is timeline animation that includes as many intermediate states, also known as keyframes, as desired in between the initial and final state. So this is, for example, animation timeline animation, where we have an initial stage and we have a final stage, and in between we can have a number of keyframes. So all these are the keyframes. We can add any number of keyframes that are required, and using the keyframe values we can change the state of the objects in every keyframe, and system will generate a sequence of changes in the in the keyframes, and finally it will create the animation. Timeline animation involves a few key concepts such as timeline, keyframes, key values and interpolation. So we will cover these things in detail also, but this is just for introduction. That timeline represents the time duration of an animation. So what is timeline? It is basically a time duration of an animation progression. For example, some animation may be of 2 seconds, some animation may be 3 seconds, some may take minutes, some may take hours. So timeline is representing that particular time duration. Then second option is the second concept is about keyframe, that denotes the state of the animated object. So keyframe contains the object and that has to be animated, and it contains the state of that particular object. So every object has may have different state in every keyframe. For example, in the first keyframe, if I have a circle whose color is red, then in the second keyframe, same circle, the color may be green. So that is basically we are changing the state. So state represent the properties of the object of an object in that particular keyframe. So a keyframe denote the state of animated object at a specific instant of a time on the timeline. Every keyframe has an associated key values that is modified by the interpolator. Now what is interpolator? Interpolator is a mathematical function which is used to find out the intermediate values. For example, if I have a value 3 at the one end and value 5 at the other end, so you can see there are number of values that comes in between. For example, 3.1, 3.2, 3.3, then value 4 is there, 4.1, 4.2, 4.9, 4.95, and then finally 5. So all these are the intermediate values. So given the two endpoints, starting point and endpoint. So what is the task of interpolator? Interpolator will find out the in between values. So it is a mathematical way to finding out this particular all the intermediate values. So this is called interpolator. So every keyframe has an associated key value. So whenever we are talking about for an animation, then we have a keyframe in the animation along the timeline, and every keyframe is associated with some key values. So key values denote the values of the object in that particular keyframe. For example, if my keyframe has a circle as an object, then the key value of that circle may correspond to the color of the circle, and the value of color is, the property is color, and the value of color is red. So that is that value has to be modified by the interpolator. The interpolator is responsible for generating the intermediate frame. So with the help of interpolator, we will create the intermediate frames. Timeline animation, we create the effect by adding the keyframes to a timeline. So at the end we have a timeline and we have a number of keyframes. The intermediate frames are generated by JavaFX with the help of interpolator. So interpolator will be there, that is the mathematical way of creating the intermediate values. So in this case our intermediate values are the frames. Though timeline animation requires more effort on the part of programmer, it gives more control to manipulate the animation effect as well. ठीक है, so that means using timeline it require more effort by the programmer, but it also, on the other side, it also provides better control for the manipulation of animation. We can create the effects that are desired by the programmer, that are desired by the end user in using timeline animation, which is not otherwise possible in transition animation, because transition animation involves only two state, in the first state and we have a final state, there is no intermediate state. But in case of timeline, we can create as many states as are required, and in every state we can perform some action on some particular objects. So accordingly, timeline animation require more effort, but it also provide, on the other hand, more control to the to manipulate the animation. So along the progression of time on a timeline, we can update the property values of an animated object, such as changing size, changing color location, and so on. This type of animation is best suited for animating complex graphical scene. So if you are creating complex scenes, for example the scenes of video games, then you can use the timeline option. Otherwise, for the simple animation, you can use transition option. So you can create the transition kind of animation if you are creating simple effects. But if you are creating a complex scene, like the scene of some animation film or some game, then you have to use the timeline animation. Then coming to the transition animation, it is best suited for planned animation, in the sense that it incorporates the animation in an internal timeline. So there are so the main point is, transition also uses timeline, but it is internal to it. So user has not to be deal with the timeline. System automatically create the timeline internally for its own use. So there are several predefined transition classes with which we can compose multiple animation that can be executed in parallel or in sequential. So predefined transition classes with which we can Java provide predefined classes. Predefined means the classes are already available in the system, which belongs to transition cases, and with which we can compose multiple animations. So we can create a fading effect and moving effect simultaneously, but we have to use two different kind of transition on the same object, and that can be executed parallelly or sequentially. Parallelly means we can use two transition classes and both are executing in the same time. And sequentially means we can use the first transition effect first, and then when that transition ends, then we start the next transition. So that is sequential. One of the example is rotate transition. This is the name of the class that implement the rotating effect by changing the degree of rotation of a node over a time. So this is comparatively simplified technique and easier to use than the timeline animation. Now we will cover the basic animation classes that are used in JavaFX. So to represent an animation in JavaFX, we have a abstract class that is called animation class that provides the core functionality for animation in JavaFX. Because it is abstract class, you cannot create the object of this class. It has many subclasses like path transition, fade transition, and timeline. All these are the subclasses of this animation class, and we have other classes also, but we will discuss mainly these three classes, and after that all the other classes are that can be used in the same way. The main properties of animation classes are: one is auto reverse, another one is cycle count, third one is rate, and fourth one is status. In auto reverse, it defines whether the animation reverses the direction or on alternate cycling or not. Cycle count defines the number of cycles in that particular animation. Rate defines the speed and direction of this animation. And status means the read-only property to indicate the status of the animation. The status can be running, stopped, or pause. So we have three kind of status that can be find out, but it is only read-only property. So we have four different properties: auto reverse, cycle count, rate, and status. All these properties belongs to animation class. These are some important methods of animation class: pause, play, and stop. Using these methods, we can pause the animation, we can play the animation, or we can stop the animation. So these are the functions that are available in animation class, and when some class inherits from the animation class, all these functions or methods are available in the inherited class also. Now coming to the path transition, let us start with the very first class that represents the path transition. This is a subclass of animation class which can move the node along a defined path over a given time. So in the path transition, we have to define a path and we can move our objects along that path. Its properties include duration, node, orientation, and path. Beside these properties, all the properties of animation classes are already available in this class because it is a subclass of animation class. So duration represents the duration of the transition, node represents the target node of this transition, the orientation represents the orientation of the node along the path, and path represents the shape whose outline will be used as a path. So duration class, again duration can be described with the help of duration class, which defines the time, the duration of time. The class defines three or four constants. One is indefinite, another one is one, third one is unknown, and zero. All these are the constants that are already defined in this particular class, path transition. And to represent, these represent indefinite duration, 1 millisecond, unknown time, and zero duration. So you can use new duration constructor also to create the duration of your own desired requirement, to create an instance of duration. And you can use add, subtract, multiply, and divide method. These are the methods that are available in duration class. You can use these methods to perform the arithmetic operations on the time that you have created, on the duration that you have created. Then second is orientation. Orientation can be either none or orthogonal to the tangent. Now none means ke whatever the default orientation of object is, that orientation will be used. And orthogonal to tangent means if our path is of circular in nature, for example this is our path, then the tangent means any line that is going, that is passing by touching the circle, and orthogonal means the direction of 90 degree to this particular line. So orthogonal to tangent orientation means the my object will be oriented along the orthogonal line. So the direction of my object will be toward the orthogonal at the 90 degree of the tangent, at the 90 degree angle with the tangent of the circle at that particular time. Then the orientation at this point will be this side. Similarly, at this point the tangent will be here, so the orthogonal to this direction will be in this way, and we can have a orientation of our object towards this way. So accordingly, wherever the orthogonal to the tangent is, my object will be oriented to that direction. Then object of this class can be created by using the constructor. Different constructors are there. One is a default constructor, then another two are the parameterized constructor that include the duration and path, or duration, path and node. So we can define all these things. So accordingly we can create the path transition. Let's see one simple example to create a path transition. This example is adapted from the book Programming in Java by Daniel Liang. So in this example I have created a pane first of all, then I have created a rectangle. At the location 00, and the width is 25 and height is 50. Then I fill the rectangle with the orange color. Then I created a circle, and then fill the circle with white color, and outline of the circle will be of black color. Then I added the circle and rectangle both into the pane, and then I have to define the animation. To define the animation, first of all I need to create the object of path transition class. Then I will set the duration. Duration is duration dot millisecond. So this will create a duration of 4000, means 4000 millisecond, that correspond to 4 seconds. So the duration of my transition will be 4 seconds. So it will, from the starting point to end point, it will cover that distance into 4 seconds. Then the set path, I have to set the path of the transition. So I am setting the circle as a path of transition, and set node, I have to set the node, set node, that is rectangle. So the transition will be acting on the rectangle. Then orientation is orthogonal to tangent. Then set cycle count, that is indefinite, timeline dot indefinite. So I am setting the cycle count as indefinite. Then auto reverse true. So all these are the properties of the transition. And finally I have to call the pt dot play. So play method will be there, which is inherited from the animation class. If we are not calling this method, then our animation will not start. So this method is important to start the animation. So in very simple few lines I have created a path transition. I am using circle as my path and rectangle as my node. So my node will move along the circle. So this is a very simple way, or in this particular simple way we are creating a transition. Now finally we have to add the pane into the scene, and add the scene into the stage, and finally show the stage. So let us see what happens when this program executes. So this is very simple and interesting program to display the animation. It will take some time for compilation. After compilation you will see the animation. Okay, here comes the animation. So you can see we have a path that is already defined with the help of a circle, and I have a node that is in the form of rectangle, and my rectangle is moving along the path. So this is a very simple path transition. It covers from end point to end point in 4 seconds, because the time duration of my transition is 4 seconds. So starting from this point to complete one circle, it takes 4 seconds. Because auto reverse is true, then it moves in the reverse direction automatically. So in this way you can create a very simple animation. You can move any object along the path. So I hope it is it clears your idea about the path transition. So let us do some experimentation with this particular program. I have removed, I am interchanging the circle with the rectangle. Now my rectangle will act as a path and my circle will act as a node. Oh, I am doing it in the wrong way. Here. My circle will act as a wrong path, and my path rectangle will act as a path, and circle will act as a node. Let us see what happens. Now my node, that is circle, has to be moved along with the rectangle. So you can see circle is moving along the rectangle, because rectangle is so I have to reposition the rectangle also. Let reposition it at location 20 from x-axis, and you can say 100 from y-axis. Rectangle, you have to increase the size of rectangle also. Suppose let it be 100 by 50, and we should also reduce the size radius of circle. Now let's see what happen. Okay, you can see my circle is moving along the rectangle now. Rectangle is acting as a path, outline of the rectangle will acting as a path, and my circle is moving along the rectangle. So this way you can create a very simple animation where you can move the object along some path. So coming to the next transition, that is fade transition. It is again a subclass of animation class. The fade transition class animates the change of the opacity in a node over a given time. So this is a specific class that will animate only the change of the opacity. So opacity of a node, opacity of a shape can be changed with this particular transition. Its properties include duration and node on which we have to perform the transition. Then it requires three values: from value, to value, and by value. The start opacity value, stop opacity value, and the incremental value on which the on the opacity for this animation. So object of this class can be generated using the constructor fade transition, or this is default constructor fade transition describing only the duration, and fade transition describing the duration and the node on which we have to apply the transition. So in the simple way, in the as we have done in the previous case, we have to create the object of fade transition class. Let's see the code now. So we have to create the object of fade transition class in the similar way. We will create a polygon. Now I am going to create a polygon. These are the points of the polygon. Fill color will be blue, and outline will be of black color in this line, and then we have to add the polygon into the pane. Finally, because we want to perform the fade transition, so fade transition FT is equal to new fade transition. I have a class 3000 milliseconds, that correspond to 3 seconds, and my PP is the object on which I want to apply the fade transition. So PP correspond to the polygon here. So polygon, I want to apply the fade transition effect on the polygon. So start set from value, it will start with the 1 opacity value, and set to value means it will go to the 0.1 value for the opacity. So 1 value means total opaque, and 0.1 means it is near to transparent. So cycle count is again indefinite, it will go for indefinite time, and auto reverse is true, that means it will fade in and then fade out. Finally, you have to call the play method of the transition so that the transition can start, and finally you have to add the pane into scene, and then scene into stage, and then you have to call the show method of this stage class so that we can see the application on your window. So this will take some time again because it is now compiling. So you can see it is very easy to use any predefined transition classes. All you need is to create the object of the class with using appropriate constructor, set some values of the class using the methods that are available, and now this is the output of this program. You can see my polygon, which has 5 sides. The fill color is blue, as you can see here. I have filled the color with blue, and it color opacity is changing from 1 to 0.1 in the duration of 3 milliseconds, and it is going from 1 to 0.1 and coming back from 0.1 to again 1. So this is due to auto reverse property that is said to be true. So this way you can create a fade in, fade out or fade transition effect. Again, in the similar way, there are a number of other transition classes that you can use in your program. All the transition classes can be used in the same way. You have to create the object of the class which using some appropriate constructor. You have to define the duration and you have to define the node on which you want to apply the transition, and then you have to set some values as per the requirement of the class, and finally you have to call the play method. So until you call the play method, your animation will not start. So this way you can create a simple animation. So I hope you understand how the transition works. So my next point is timeline. To understand the timeline, it is another class that is derived from the animation class. So this is a general class which can be used to program any kind of animation. This is advantage of timeline, that with the help of transition kind of animation like fade transition or path transition, we are performing some specific animation. Like path transition can only perform path movement of the node along the path. Fade transition can only perform the fading effect only. So you cannot manipulate all these things as per your will. But in case of timeline, it is a general class. General class means you can perform any kind of operation using timeline, and you can create the program for any animation. To understand the timeline, you must understand some key concept. One is the key value, another one is duration, then keyframe, then interpolator. All these are the important concepts that you need to understand before the timeline concept. So the key concept, we start with the key value. So the key value is the name of the class. In timeline animation, keyframes are interpolated over predefined values to produce the animation. So as we have already discussed, that keyframes are important in the case of timeline. You have to create the keyframes. So keyframes contain the objects which has a major change in that particular time duration. So keyframes are interpolated over the predefined values. So you have some predefined values and you are interpolating those values from the initial state to final state, and you are producing the animation. For example, circle's opacity property that can be used to produce the fade in and fade out effect. So opacity property is the property that we have to interpolate. So we have a predefined values, means opacity 1 and opacity 0.1. So these are predefined. From 1 to we will have to go to 0.1, and from 0.1 we have to come again to the value 1. So this by interpolating these two predefined values, we are creating the effect of animation. So such values which are interpolated for a given time duration are called key values. Now what are the key values? These are the values which are interpolated for a given time duration. So key values class represent such values. So to represent a key value, we have a class in Java that is called key value. So key value class has three main things. One is the target, another one is an end value, and third one is the interpolator. So by default it will use the linear interpolator, but you can use another interpolator that are already defined in Java. So most frequently used is linear interpolator, and which is the default one. So the target is that some Java FX property. What is target here? Target is some property that represent the property of some component or some shape. For example, opacity in case of circle. So opacity is our target property, and the end value represent the value of the target that we want to achieve. And interpolator is the interpolator that will use the mathematical formula, mathematical way to produce the end value from the starting value. Then key value class provides two constructor. One is a constructor with two arguments. First argument is target, second argument is end value, and second constructor is accepting three argument: target, end value, and interpolator. So this is example of creating you can say key values. Suppose I have a rectangle whose parameters are 0, 0 and 50, 50. 0, 0 is x and y values, 50, 50 is the width and height of the rectangle. Now I have to define two key values on the properties that we want to change during the animation. Suppose I want to change the opacity of this particular rectangle, then I will create a start key value with the rectangle dot opacity property and setting it to 0. So I am telling this way that the opacity property of my rectangle, the start key value will be 0, and end key value in the similar way I have defined another variable that the opacity property of rectangle will be 1. So this is my start key value. At starting it will be 0 and at the end it will be 1. So I have defined two key value variable, start key value and end key value, for a single property of a rectangle object. So a rectangle object may have other properties also, and you can, in the similar way, you can create the start key value and end key value for every property. Then second option that you need to understand is second concept, that is duration. So it represents the amount of time for which each cycle of animation goes on. Then duration of animation can be represented by a class that is named as duration. This class can represent time in millisecond, second, minutes and hours. So you can create duration object in three different ways, either using the constructor or using the factory method or using the value of method. So the first way, that is using the constructor, you can create the duration object by calling the constructor of duration class and passing the value. So whatever the value you pass here, that will be always treated as millisecond. In the second way, you can create the duration in the terms of millisecond, second, minutes and hours by calling the appropriate method. All these methods are static method of duration class, and duration, you can call it with the name duration, which is the name of the class, dot name of the method. Like in the first way, we are creating 10 millisecond time, second we are creating 10 second duration, in the third case we are creating 10 minutes duration, and in the fourth case we are creating 10 hours duration. Then the third method of creating duration object is of value of method, which is again a static method, and you can call it directly using the class name. The arguments of value of method is a number followed by any of these four values. Either you can use ms or s or m or h. For example, duration dot value of 10.0 ms. 10.0 ms, this is the number, and this is your specifier about the time, that is 10 milliseconds. So you are creating a duration of 10 millisecond object by passing a string that represent 10 milliseconds. After creating duration, then you have to define the keyframe. To define a keyframe, you have a keyframe class. A keyframe defines the state of a node at a specified point in the timeline. It is very important to understand. So our timeline may have number of keyframes. For example, if I have a timeline like this, so at the first second, second second, third second, fourth second, fifth second, I can have a different keyframe. For example, here I have a keyframe 1. Here I have a keyframe 2, where the circle is representing at this position. In second case, circle can be positioned at the another location. In the third frame, my circle can have another color, or you can say another position. So in this way, every keyframe define the state of the circle at that particular time. So keyframe define the state of a node at a specified point on the timeline. The target state is defined by the key values. How to define the state? With the help of key values. So key values are there that are associated with every keyframe, and each keyframe is executed sequentially at a specified time interval. The keyframe encapsulate four things: an instance and instant on the timeline that represent the keyframe belongs to what time at the timeline. Then the set of key values, Then we have a name that is optional value that define the name of the keyframe, and then action event handler. This is that means that we have an event handler also that is associated with the keyframe. When the keyframe time is there, then that event will be happening, and using that event handler we can perform some task that should be occur at that particular time. So the instant on a time with which the keyframe is associated is defined by the duration. Set of key values that we have already discussed in the previous slide that define the end value of the target for the keyframe. And the keyframe may have optionally a name that can be used as a cue point to jump to the instant defined by it during an animation. And optionally we can attach an action event handler also to a keyframe. Action event handler is called when the time for the keyframe arrives during the animation. These are the constructor of the keyframe that can be used to create the keyframe. Different constructors are available. You can use any of these constructor to create the keyframe. Some accept time and event handler and key values, some accept time and key values only, another accept time and event handler and key values. So different combinations are available. You can call any constructor as per your requirement. This is example of creating a keyframe. In this example I have created an image view IV that represents some image on the screen. Then key value, I have created a key value start key value that represent the translate x property of IV. IV is my object, so I am performing the translate x operation. That means moving the object on the screen. So this property represent the x position on the screen. So initial value of this property will be 0. Then end key value. Similarly, I have created another key value that is end key value for the same property, translate x property of IV object, and the end value will be 100 in my case. So system will use the 0 as the initial value and 100 as the end value. Then we have created the keyframe. So because I have to create an animation, so I will create the two frames. One is the start frame and another one is end frame. In the start frame, the duration is duration of this frame will be 0. That means this frame will appear at the 0 duration on the timeline, and the starting value will be represented by start key value, which we have defined in the previous step. So by using these two values, I am defining a start frame. I am telling the system that during the 0th time of my animation, using these key values, I will create a frame. Similarly, I can define the end frame, which will be at the duration 3 seconds. So I have created the time period. I have set the time period of this particular frame at the 3 seconds. So with value end value, end key values. So I have created two frames, start frame and end frame, by using the constructor of the keyframe class. And using this constructor, I can put these keyframes at the position that are defined by my time period at the 0 position and at the 3rd second position. Then comes the concept of timeline. Finally, how to represent a timeline? A timeline animation is used to for animating any property of the node. You can animate any property. An instance of the timeline class. So we have a class that is called timeline. To represent a timeline, we have to create the instance of this class. Using a timeline animation involves the 4 steps. First is constructing the keyframe. Second is create a timeline object with the keyframe. Third one is set the animation property, and fourth one is to play the animation. So first we have to create the keyframe. To create the keyframe, we have to create the duration object, and we have to create the key value object. So using these two values, we will create the keyframe. So timeline class can be created by several constructor. One is default constructor, another one are parameterized constructor. So as per your requirement, you can create the timeline using any of the constructor. So this is example, as we have completed in the previous step, that I have created a image view, set the height and width and set the rotate property of this image view and added the image view into the pane. And finally, I have created a start key value, end key value. Based upon these key values, I have created a start frame and end frame. So start frame will be started at the zero duration, end frame will be started at the third second. So start key value will be used as the starting value and end key values will be used as the end values, and the in between values will be created with the help of interpolator. So after defining the key frames and after defining the key values, now I need to define a timeline. To define a timeline, I have to create a object of timeline class. So object of timeline class, when I am creating object, I will pass the frame names, end frame and start frame, as a in the constructor as a argument. So I can pass as many frame as required in this way. So using all the frame, the timeline will be created. Then I set the cycle count. These are the properties of the timeline, that I can set the cycle count and I can set the auto reverse property to true, and finally I have to call the play method. So again, you can see it is very simple. If you understand the concept, then you can create any timeline. For example, the thing is, you have to create some object. You have to think upon the key values for that object, any property of that object. For example, here I am using translate x and translate x property. Similarly, you can use translate y property also. So translate x will move the object in the x direction, translate y will move the object in the y direction. So after creating the key values, so I am using translate x. Beside this, we can use another property like opacity also. So you can define the start key value for opacity, end key value for opacity. So you have to create that much number of objects for that. And finally, you have to create the frames. You can create start frame, you can create end frame by passing the start key value and end key value to the frame. And finally, after creating the keys, after creating the frame, after deciding the duration, you have to create the timeline. So creating timeline is again very simple. You have to just create the object of timeline class by using the appropriate constructor, then set some property of the timeline animation, and finally you have to call the play method. So until you call the play method, your animation will not be started. So this is very simple way of creating a animation using timeline. So you can extend the idea as per your understanding, as per your requirement. So let's see the example in running state. So this is the same program that I have just shown you. So finally, I have to add all these things into the scene, and scene will be added into the stage, and stage will be shown using the show method. So when I execute this method, you can see the object, that is basically a image of car that is loaded, that object is moving to and fro as per the time. So it is using the timeline. So I have defined two frames, one is the start frame and one is the end frame. All the in between frames will be created by the system automatically using some interpolator. So this is a very simple animation. You can perform this kind of task using timeline. We have a more control using timeline method, using timeline object, and you can use any kind of animation with the help of timeline. So I hope this concept this clears your concept about using animation. So there are a number of possibilities, number of that depends upon your imagination, that you can create the animation of any kind with the help of animation facility that is available in JavaFX. So that is all about animation. I hope you get the idea how to create your projects using animation. So if you have some doubt, some problem, you can discuss with me on the WhatsApp group, or you can email me, or you can put it on the e-learning website that our university is using. So that's all. Try it, try the program, and learn from all these lectures.